Brasil, you're watching Lockhouse Rock Show.
E aí, Marina, e aí, galera do Plantão Mix. Hoje a gente veio aqui no Via Funchal aproveitar a passagem da Tania Turman e a gente vai bater um papinho com ela. Hello, how are you?
Hi, I'm very fine. Happy to be back in Brazil.
Yes, welcome back. What Lies Beneath is the longest tour in your career, right? What are your plans after the tour is over?
Get back home! My God! I haven't been at home in let me say, 5.5 months.
Really?
Yes, and I've done a lot of concerts, not only rock concerts, but before this I did a classical concert tour in Finland. Yeah, it's been a long road with 5 pieces of luggage and many months. Getting back home, it's a dream come true, yeah.
Last year you participated in Angra's show in Rock in Rio, and there were a lot of people who were there only to see you. Tell me more about this experience. Did you expect this public reaction?
To be honest, I didn't. But to be honest, it was amazing. It was such an incredible feeling to see all the tears in the people. They collapsed, sort of. When I ran to the stage, it was amazing to see that and to feel that love and passion from the people in Rock in Rio. It was incredible. And I will never forget that. Seriously, I told the Angra guys also, like, wow, that, like, I get goosebumps right now if I think of it.
Everybody was screaming your name. That was also, I was there.
It was good. Yeah. Did you scream?
Yes. A few years ago, you toured with Scandinavian Nights Project. Do you plan on touring with this project again?
No, it's hard because all the musicians in this lineup, you know, they are busy on their own. They are whether having children already, and it was so many years ago that we did this. It was a lot of fun, but they are busy in their lives. I would love to do that though. But I have other side projects, like Harus, for example, is a project of mine, is a lineup from Finland. Is a classical lineup, and with Harus, hopefully, we will be able to also tour abroad in future.
And how was this experience to you?
It was great. I mean, it was. It's always when I perform classical music, I have seen since many years already that there are a lot of rock fans coming to see my concerts from all over the world, and it's even for them. It's such an event. They perhaps never been in a church or a beautiful opera theater, and so I even today I prefer making concerts, rock concerts, in a theater. Like, we filmed a DVD in Buenos Aires just before, no, not in Buenos Aires, but in Argentina, just before coming to Brazil, and it was in a beautiful theater, opera house. So my fans were like, wow, because isn't it? It's a experience. It's an event, and it suits for my music very, very well. I'm never gonna go tell the world I'm still around.
I didn't fly. And back when you stopped being part of Nightwish, how did you see those times, and how do you see it now?
Of course, it was really tough. It was really, really tough for several years, and the split and all that. It was horrifying. You don't wish that for your worst enemy, seriously, what I went through. Not only mentally, but only physically, it took a dime, really. But now, after so many years, I feel like everything what has happened to me in my life in these several years, I really breathe, I feel happy, I feel I enjoy of first being a woman, second being an artist. It's unbelievable.
That was exactly what I would ask you. Do you think that the lack of female rock musicians nowadays coming from a cultural factor, or women are just not that interested in becoming rock musicians?
Yeah, I really wish that there would be more of us. As I am very proud of all these girls that are coming to tell me, you know, that, oh, you've been the one who has been inspiring me. It's amazing to hear that. For example, here in Brazil, come on, in these 2 days of time, how many girls have tattooed their my signature in their neck or in their breast or in somewhere? I'm like, what's going on in here? Don't do that, please. I mean, and most of these girls have started singing because they've seen in me something. And that something is so huge, sparkle, and so important in their life that they go ahead with that. They have a wish, they have a dream. And that's what I do. I have a dream and I live in it.
Nightwish released a new album. Did you hear that?
Not complete album, no.
Some tracks?
Only, I think I've heard only one, actually one track.
A single?
Yes. Played in the radio. Yeah, in Finland, yes. Yeah.
And did you like it?
Well, to be honest, I am not really too much into the music of Nightwish. I wish them all the best, though.
And I heard about you are Paulo Coelho's fan, right? Do you know any other Brazilian writer or Brazilian books?
Oh, no, I don't. But Paulo has taken all my time. Yeah. And I know that he... it's incredible. I mean, the first book was The Alchemist that I wrote, that I read from him many years ago already. And it just something moved in me. And after that, I've been reading all of his books, and I know that he's writing a new one, so we can wait. We can expect something good to be.
You wrote some songs based on his books, right? Which books was that?
It was a part of them. He gave me the permission to use his text. Like, we've been in touch with Pablo for some, I think already for 2 years or something. And I was supposed to meet him in Zurich last tour, but he was busy and we couldn't make it. But I love him, I adore him. But the books were Alchemist, and then there was the book of how is this translation of English? The River Piedra, where I wept, or along the River Piedra where I wept. And it was, it's just about dreams, as he's writing about dreams in general.
You can say who, which of these girls that I'm going to say you could take. You could say 10.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I will tell you the list. Christina Scabe, Flora Jensen, Liv Christine, Emily, Joan Jett, Lita Ford, Dotto, Lady Gaga, Simone Simons.
This is a tough one. But you know what? I will go for the lady.
Lady?
Lady. And you know why? Because I saw her performing piano piece on her own, and she is unbelievable. An artist who goes wherever the hell she wants to go. She has done incredible. Started from scratch, and she has risen up like a rocket rising, and she's very talented, actually, this lady. So she would be the 10 for me.
And you want to say something to your Brazilian fans?
Estou muito, muito feliz de estar aqui novamente.
Wow, your accent is excellent.
Muito obrigada.
Thank you very much. A pleasure talking to you. Thank you. Valeu.